in terms of your, like, because you have an amateur career and now you're going to have your first pro fight coming up on Friday, right? So when, like, how do you decipher whether you're ready or not, and whether you can make that leap? Like, do you, like, talk with your coaches, or is it kind of just like a feeling you have where you're like, I'm ready to go?
A little bit of both. So if you don't have that feeling where you're like, I'm ready to go, then you definitely shouldn't be taking a pro fight.
Probably. That's, yeah.
Sure. Yeah. So that was, I'm sure there were plenty of people who would have told me to take a pro fight before I was ready, you know, plenty of gyms, especially smaller gyms, where they would have loved the opportunity to have, like, brought me into the cage for a pro fight, before I was actually ready. And, you know, I've had opportunities that I've turned down, like, fairly big ones. So Bellator does, like, this thing where, like, where they have their contracted fighters and then they bring local fighters onto a card to keep costs down, you know?
Yeah.
And I had one of those opportunities where I could have fought in Bellator, like, a year and a half ago.
Oh,
and,
wow.
Yeah. And it seemed like it was happening way too fast. And I sat down.
Would you be fighting, like, a guy more, like, on your level, or are they going to throw you against a Bellator guy?
They wanted me to fight Romero Cotton, who was a 3-time Division II national champ in wrestling and had already had, like, five pro fights.
Oh, dang.
And at 185. So it was,
oh,
like,
wow, yeah.
All around wasn't a good idea for me. Mm-hmm. At the time, I really could have – it was, like, right before I was going to move to the lab, and I sat down with my coach at home, and we talked about it. It was like, no. It was a huge risk, and it would have been really dumb to start my pro career out on such a giant risk, you know. You take a loss right away in your pro career and that follows you forever. Whereas, yep, like, you lose in your amateur career, who cares? It doesn't follow you anywhere. It gets erased once you go pro.
Right.
But really when you really know you need to go pro is when you just stop getting amateur fights. And that's where I was, where I had been on a list to get an amateur fight for like 3-4 months and nobody was calling. The people who called would call me back, you know, a day later, like, oh, we can't do it. The guy backed out, this and that. And that was basically it. And I was sitting next to Coach Crouch at practice one day and I was just like, let's do it. Like, I'm ready. I want to fight. It's been a while. Like, I'm ready. I'll do a pro fight. And he was like, all right, let's make it happen. I think you're ready. And then that's the conversation you got to have. Like, you need to have the conversation first with yourself and then with your coach. And people think it's like this big deal, like, oh, he's going pro. It's literally just like a phone call, like, hey, find me a pro fight. You know, it's not like Tony Hawk. That's where I stole that from, was because Tony Hawk went pro when he was like 14 and everybody like always asked him, like, oh, that's so crazy. He was like, no, I went to a tournament and there was a piece of paper that said amateur and said pro. And I checked the pro box. That was all that happened. And that's kind of what happens in MMA too. Like, there's no cake, you know, there's no, no party, no streamers, nothing like that. It's just, it's time for a pro fight. I shouldn't be fighting amateur anymore. I'm ready to get paid for this.
Yeah, for sure.